Hello and welcome to this tutorial series. In the next videos, we'll quickly go through the basic functions of our Wwise integration to get you started. This is especially helpful if you are new to Wwise or Godot. These tutorials won't cover everything, but you should be able to get started and have the opportunity to explore the integration on your own. The tutorials will include the installation and configuration process, using the custom nodes, loading banks and posting events, setting game parameters, switches and states. In the end, we will learn about exporting a project and how to compile the integration. Let's start with the installation process. You can find the integration on GitHub. I will post a link to the repository below. The fastest way to install the integration is to go to the releases section of the repository and to download the integration app for your platform. In my case, I'm using macOS right now. In the integration app, you can select the platforms you wish to target. I will select macOS and Windows for this example. Then you need to select the path to the Godot project file. I have created an empty project for this demonstration. Feel free to use any project you like. After clicking on Install, the app will download the required files to the project and automatically activate the integration. Now we can open the Godot project and see if everything works. Let's just create an empty scene and start a scene to see if Wwise initializes correctly. And we should get a message in the output console saying that Wwise was successfully initialized. We can also verify that Wwise-related entries are enabled in the Autoload and Plugins tab of the project settings. In the Autoload tab, we can see that the Wwise and WAPI libraries are enabled. And in the Plugins tab, the Picker, Custom Nodes and the IDs Converter plugins should be enabled. Let's also verify that we can access the custom nodes, for example the AK Bank or the AK Event node. As you can see here in the inspector, the event field of the AK Event node is empty. And the reason for this is that we haven't configured our Wwise authoring project yet, haven't exported the sound banks to the Godot project, and haven't converted the Wwise IDs to GD script. This is what we will do in the next video. See you next time.